And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're gonna head out to a few more systems. Check out some planets. And look for war assets before we head on to the next missions, which is Nimbus Cluster, Minos Wasteland. Hold on 1 second, actually. This is very fast. You know, I think this mouse just keeps... Hold on 1 second. This should go slower. Nope. That's better. I don't know why it keeps doing that. It keeps re-accelerating itself. I don't know. Ex-Cerberus Scientists. Asari Colony. Oh, now it's too slow. Quarians over here. Valhallan Threshold. That's a new system. New for this game. So let's see what's out there. Oh. What? No planets. We got Paz and Micah. Rahil, Leia with... Nope. No planets. That's the... relay I'm hearing. Wait, I heard that.
I found something.
Huh. 95 units of fuel, that's it. Well, we were... Oh, that's it. That's all we need, okay. It always throws me how we're, like, not close to it. Alright. Well, that's easy. Nothing to see there. Rahil Leia system. And now the Paz system. And here we have one planet. I've got to fix this mouse. This isn't crazy. This is in-crazy. It's a cross between crazy and insane. Garvik planet. In 354 CE, Garvik was considered a bargain world, given to the Krogan to placate them because no one else wanted to live on such a frozen rock. Technically a life-bearing world, Garvik had a small farm belt around its equator and well-insulated marine life in its seas. By the turn of the century, the Krogan had completely adapted, breeding hundreds of younglings per family in vast underground bunkers. By the turn of the next century, Garvug's narrow strips of coral reef had been destroyed by overfishing and pollutants, and excess Krogan took to the stars to find another planet to consume. Garvik was treated as an object lesson by the Citadel Council. The Krogan could not be trusted to check their own numbers. Today, Garvik is a frozen wasteland, home to corporate eco-engineering efforts trying to implement sustainable agri- and aquaculture practices. Krogan and Vorcha packs are a constant threat, and the corporations pay mercenaries well to keep their operations safe. Do they now? I mean, I guess I could get used to this. I could always adjust it in-game as well. Oh, I heard that.
Signal confirmed.
Oh my. Next scan will bring them right on top of us. 160 units of fuel. We're being rather cheap with the fuel here, aren't we? 50% assets. Well, the other one must be on the planet. Can I just investigate now? Enter or- well... Hold on.
Reapers eluded.
I enter orbit, not investigate. I'm having trouble turning. Right, let me just adjust this a little bit more. Now I'm coming in the wrong side. Sheesh. Way up here somewhere. Probe launched. Prothean data drives. Excellent. So, my voice is still a little scratchy. I'm still... Technically, I don't have a cold right now. I'm just congested. So, go figure. Now, if we could not die, great. Successful. Cool. Which probably means in this mica system... There's three, because we have 50% recovered, and 1, 2, 3. So let's see what's here. Unless there's some hidden system or something, which I doubt. What's this over here? Is that a thingy? Okay, the mica is Raphael planet. Largest of the... Oh! I remember the... From Mass Effect 2, the Ezo Trio. Largest of the Ezo Trio, Israfil is a silicate-heavy carbonaceous asteroid. It is home to approximately 40 species of microorganisms in its liquid water, and was blamed as the source of the prion-based biowarfare agent Ehi. Exotic humanoid encephalopathy. Used by the terrorist group Totenkopf. In their attack on Gargarin Station in 2184. Totenkopf. That means death something, I believe. While many in the scientific community protested that Israfil did not have sufficient atmosphere or evolutionary history to sustain life at the prion level, the asteroid and its Ezo miners were nevertheless quarantined to reassure the public that the Systems Alliance was taking action. Though no evidence has yet been found that Ehi originated from Israfil or is even synthesized in a local lab, the SSV Manila and a team of epidemiologists maintain watch over the asteroid ship's traffic for now. Population is 1,006. Okay. Duma. Home to 51 moons, including the prebiotic moon Anaphiel, Duma is a standard hydrogen helium gas giant with violent surface winds exceeding 1,900 kilometers per hour. Like its sister planet Elohi, it is believed to be an extrasolar capture. I know, we have two more. Here's one. We have two more in this belt. I remember it from Mass Effect 2. Elohi. A small hydrogen-helium gas giant formed around a metallic hydrogen core, Elohi was the site of a rare astronomical event late last year. The comet Asaro completed its orbit of 70 galactic standard years and traveled so close to the giant that it was captured as a moon. Dozens of space probes from around the galaxy recorded this moment. Elohi is within the frost line of its parent star, where gas giants do not usually form. For this reason, it is believed to be an extrasolar capture. Next one here, Farlas. One of a trio of asteroids formed around an element zero core, Farlas is the easiest to mine for low-yield Ezo. A carbonaceous asteroid, Farlas has a trace of water-bearing minerals and organic carbon in the form of kerogen. Next, Kakabel. Kakabel? The second asteroid in the system formed around an element zero core, Kakabel is another carbonaceous asteroid, with a surface made of hydrated minerals such as carbonates and clays. Beneath its icy surface is liquid water with some amino acids. The surface of Kakabel is pitted and scarred with strip mining stations where the Quarians took as much Ezo as possible before moving on. Stuff. Anything else in this belt? Any fuel to be found? they might be just all on the asteroid, since there's three of them. The, war assets. Or whatever we have to find. We're only gonna get a couple good scans of them. Well, we got two right away. Excellent. I wish the thing would keep turning because my mouse goes off the pad. Probe away. Nice. Element Zero Converter. Makes sense. We're finding out on a planet formed from Element Zero. Fuel. 340 units. Nice, we're full. It's gonna come right from here. Nope, it's not something. It's on that one.
Reapers eluded.
I don't know if I'll have a chance to get in there. I might get away. I hope. Then we'll be completely done. Pretty small cluster, huh? Probe launched. Emergency fuel pods. I say that, guys, because I miss Edie saying probe away and all the stuff that she's used to say. Can we get out of here now? 100 assets. 100%. Yay!
Faster than light jump successful.
Thank you very much. Let's get the hell out of here. Done with Valhallan Threshold. That's the... I keep thinking I'm hitting something. But we've recovered everything, and that's the mass relay. Alright, so good. We're not heading there for quite a while. Nima Cluster was already there. 100%. Nimbus Cluster is a new one, but we might as well just go there when we're ready to do that mission. Anos Basin? Wait. Not completely sure. Let me check my notes. See if we've been to Anos Basin. That's why I'm so glad I left these notes for myself. Of all the systems we've been to, we have been there. That's the one with the diplomatic ship that we met on. Okay. Way back. Horsehead Nebula. Tourist Stream. Gemini Sigma. Attican Beta. Hades Gamma. Really? What does this bounce off of? It's funny. There's something there. There's a relay there, but there's no system. Tried clicking on it. Nothing happened. Kite's Nest. Exodus Cluster. I thought there was another one. Sorry, guys. Just trying to be thorough here. Yeah. Alright, I guess we'll do this mission. Let's head to the Minos Wasteland, which you've been to. I actually hate to start it now, I just don't want to leave a 15-minute episode. Going to Arrae. Have you been to this Arrae? What is it? Minos Wasteland we're in? I wonder if this is a newly discovered system. Yeah, only Fortis was here. Okay, so we'll check out these planets. Have to add Arrae to my little list. Eros. Eros is a Turian word meaning overlook or pleasant view, not to be confused with humanity's mythological Eros. The name, or Eros, or the name refers to the planet's nearly absent atmosphere, allowing visiting probes and rovers a sweeping view of its volcanic mountains. Eros's hematite deposits give the world a reddish color. Accessible deposits of iron and copper have attracted second-tier Turian and Volus conglomerates that robo-mine the surface. I'll go there last. Antanax. A large terrestrial planet, Antanax has been passed over by the Turians and potential investors alike. When the Turians won the planet from the Krogan, they sought to sell mineral rights but ultimately found no buyers. One survey team dubbed it a stinking world with nothing to recommend it but brimstone and bad steel. And, like Jellix, the planet was soon forgotten. Despite being farther from its parent star than Jellix, Antanax has a thick atmosphere of nitrogen, methane, and ethane, greenhouse gases that retain significant heat. There are few valuable minerals on Antanax. The most abundant being sulfur and iron. Oh, I see. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 points. Oh. Let's go here next. I don't know. Oh, Antanax. Duh. Antanax. Okay, never mind. Nerus. For some reason I thought there was another planet and I miscalculated. Nerus, a moderate-sized hydrogen-helium gas giant, is of mild interest to Turian scientists because of its abnormal atmospheric composition. The planet has only a fraction of the expected methane, with high levels of carbon monoxide and ethylene instead. Before I look here, should I scan for stuff? Just see if there's anything. So this is one of these smaller missions. Which might be quite short itself. I don't see anything. And nothing's coming for us. There might not be anything here in this system. The system is so well hidden that the Reapers don't even know it's here. Much less us until right now. Alright, I don't think there's anything in this system. Jellix. Find Ex-Cerberus Scientists. I'm gonna read the description first. Jellix was given to the Krogan after the Rachni Wars, but bitterly contested in the Krogan Rebellions and reconquered by the Turians. This left the Turians as caretakers to a Levo amino acid-based world that they could not inhabit themselves but were unwilling to give up. In cooperation with the Vol Protectorate, the Turians attempted to rent the planet out for colonization. Between the high price and a surface littered with unexploded ordnance, however, Jellix found few reputable tenants. Its most notable inhabitants were penal colonies. To those who know of it today, Jellix is a symbol of tragic waste, an entire garden world nearly forgotten by the galaxy at large. Colony founded in 658 CE by the Krogan, 801 CE by the Turian. Population is 54,000. Capital is Anapondus. That's land. Ashley! We're gonna bring Ashley. It's been almost literally forever since I had Ashley in a party. In the first Mass Effect 1, I don't think I hardly ever brought her on a mission. Or Caden, because I didn't find them that interesting. And I didn't like Ashley's kind of, you know, xenophobic stance. Although to a certain degree I can understand it, being, you know, she's been fighting aliens all her life. Alright, so that's her stuff. We're gonna select. This could be interesting. Ashley versus Liara. Let the best woman win. With the best bust. Alright, what you using? You're not going to use any of that. She's only going to use a sniper rifle and assault rifle. Okay, well, if you're going to use the Valiant... Damage is better. Accuracy is just the same. For the Mantis. Sucky fire rate. But what do you want? It's a sniper rifle. Let's have her use the Mantis. M92 Mantis. I'm gonna increase the damage. And accuracy, 20%. 15%. I'm gonna take that so we don't increase our weight so much. Okay, assault rifles. She's got the M8 Avenger. 'Mathawk. I like the 'Mathawk. We have so many to choose from. Wow. Chakram Launcher. Damage is like here. We'll have her use the Chakram Launcher. And we will increase damage. And accuracy. Confirmed. Is this her top level? Because I've been stuck at 4 points forever. Level 55. Alright, so Ashley. There's a character on Saturday Night Live called Ashley Ashley. I'm probably the only one who remembers it. She was a character by Nora Dunn, and I think she played a reporter or interviewer or something like that. Talk show host or something. But I really, the only funny thing about it was how she says, "I'm Ashley Ashley." Otherwise, it was like, you know, it was boring. Sniper rifle damage. Power damage. Let's increase power damage. Squad mate weapon damage. Assault rifle damage. Let's help the squad. Cool. She is leveled up with Alliance officer. Inferno grenade I don't place a priority on because once you run out of grenades, you know. But I will be putting some in there. Excuse me. Disruptor ammo. Concussive shot I do enjoy. Marksman. Force and damage by 30%. Actually, no, I did party with Ashley on one mission, and it was with Liara, I believe. And I don't know, it's all blurring together. Not sure if we're at does Mass Effect 2 or 3. I'm thinking the beginning of 3. I don't even know. So crazy. Alright, increase force and damage by 30 or impact radius. Let's do radius. Force and damage to frozen targets. Too specific for me. Recharge speed, why not? Properties of the active ammo power. I'll do this one. The Shredder. Damage to organics by 100% over 10 seconds. Increase force by 50%. Pretty powerful. Disruptor ammo. So I haven't taken these. Health damage bonus by 3%. Shield and barrier damage bonuses by 12%. Not a hell of a lot. We gain disruptor ammo at 50%. Effectiveness. I'll do that. Increase ammo capacity. Squad mates, I don't think, run out of ammo, so. Increase headshot damage by 20. Do they take headshots? I don't know. Increase health damage by 5%, shield and barrier damage by 20. Or improve the odds of stunning a target. Let me just take the damage. And now, I'm just gonna dump my last one and two Inferno grenade. We got two more grenades here, so I'll probably just continue down. Improve this one again next time. Damage or impact radius? I'm gonna do radius. I can always take damage here, but not one extra grenades, right? I can always do that for damage. Increase shrapnel by one fragment. Okay. And Liara's has just 1 point. Done. I'll probably be cutting the episode here.
What's the word? Do we know how long these scientists have been holed up out here? Our intel is minimal.
Ma'am, I'm picking up chatter from a Cerberus squad engaging the supply depot.
Engaging the scientists?
And if I'm reading it right, sounds like more troops are on the way.
Okay, set us down then get out of here. I need these scientists alive.
We're gonna have to stop them from being killed. There's a mission like that in the first game. And I saved most of them. I think 4 died or something. It's kind of hard to get past that tower shield. She looks familiar. And she's dead. Apparently. Oh, Jacob!